Egypt, Persia, India, China. Kublai Khan was the emperor of which country? Egypt, Persia, India, China.
It's China.
Got lifelines if you need them.
That was China, because I think Marco Polo went there. Worked for him.
Final answer?
Yes.
You just won £64,000.
He grins and gets a handshake from Chris.
It's getting a bit serious now, isn't it? Well, you've got £64,000. Yeah, have a look. But we don't want to give you that. I'll give you that. You've got £32,000 at this moment. Obviously, you can walk away with that cheque for £64,000. The crucial thing is, though, you've saved those lifelines well back. You've got a 50-50 still, and you've got to phone a friend. Question number 12, if you want to play for it, is worth £125,000. Have a look. Question number 12 of a possible 15. Here it is. Who composed the opera Billy Budd? Edward Elgar. Ralph Vaughan Williams. William Walton. Benjamin Britten.
Now 50-50, please.
You can. Computer, take away two wrong answers. Leave Pete the right answer and one remaining random wrong answer. What's that done?
It goes for nothing. Benjamin Britten.
What does it goes for nothing?
Make a decision. It's Benjamin Britten.
How sure are you?
Not particularly, but I'm going for it.
Don't want to phone a friend?
Final answer.
Why did you go for Benjamin Britten? It's good you did. It is the right answer. You got £125,000. Let's have that one, please. Thank you.
Chris tears up the cheque. The end.
Arrows, archers, throwers and knowers. This show has all the darting fun. Bullseye's next. New Saturday at 5 over on Pick, among the forests and ruins of Madagascar, it's Gangs of Lima Island.
You've made us wait long enough. What's your final answer? Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Time is on my side.
Yes, it is.
I said time is on my side.
It's time to act on the climate crisis today, not one day. And E.ON have the solutions to help.
You can't play here!
Come on.
We rise by lifting each other. Kenko, made to uplift. Darling, hold my hand. Oh, won't you
hold my hand? 'Cause I don't wanna walk alone. Nothing beats a Jet 2 holiday. So don't miss out. We have millions of free child place holidays available. Book now for this summer and get 22 kilograms of baggage included. Jet 2 Holidays. Package holidays you can trust. Aptronatal protected.
Watch the Hungarian Grand Prix live on Sky Sports. To add Sky Sports, go to sky.com/sports.
With Sky Store, you're in for an out-of-this-world adventure.
The Guardians of the Galaxy have no place in my world.
Kiss your mom with that face?
Some corners of the universe consider him God.
It's a face-off.
Yeah! Well, I guess we'll die trying.
I decided die trying ain't our thing no more.
Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3, available now in Sky Store.
I'm getting some static from polyester blouses, and I can smell the hairspray from here. It must be time to play Bullseye on Challenge.
Congratulations, number three. You said cup of tea. That's the top answer. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Bully, the cartoon bull, drops down from the public house sign, enters the premises where a darts contest is advertised. As people drink, he picks up a set of darts, takes aim, and scores a bullseye.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you welcome your host for the evening, Jim Bowen?
Nice having with us on this pre-Christmas bullseye. We're all excited and we're full of Christmas spirit. It's marvellous. So let's meet the first couple tonight who are going to play with us on Bullseye.
From Time Tees, Mickey and John Gray.
Nice to see you.
And John,
how are you? All the way from?
Newcastle.
Oh, way up by A?
Up north.
Yes. We haven't had many Geordies on. You are Geordies, aren't you, from Newcastle?
Yeah.
That's right. What do you do for a living, Mickey?
I'm a labourer.
Well, you're lucky to be working up there at the moment, aren't you? And what about you, John?
I work for a soft drinks company.
Soft drinks?
Yeah.
Oh. Are you a cleric? Or...
Oh, no, on the wagons.
You drive the wagons?
Yeah,
and you drop the stuff off and all the business? Pop, we used to call it,
didn't
we?
That's it.
Pop pie. How do you get the general knowledge bit?
Do a lot of crosswords.
Ah, you see.
Crosswords, that sort of thing.
Yeah. Are you married, either of you, both of you?
No. I am, yeah.
You're married?
Yeah.
Well, he looks quite happy. any children, John?
Yeah, one. Two-year-old boy.
Yeah. Do you play darts for a local team, Mickey?
No, I play it as a hobby.
You don't play for a pub or anything?
No.
I see. It's a lovely accent, that's a musical accent, that, isn't it? Nice to have you with us. Mickey, off you go over there. And John,
right,
into your little seat, and we'll move on and welcome the second couple who are going to play with us on Bullseye.
From London, Graham Tedder and Betty McClellan.
Nice to see you. And Betty. How are you, Betty? You feeling all right now?
Not too bad.
Good girl. Where are you from, both of you?
Berkhamsted in Hertfordshire.
Berkhamsted. The canal runs through there. What's the canal that runs through Berkhamsted?
Grand Union.
The Grand Union, that's right. We pass it on the train going down to London, that's it. What do you do for a living, Graham?
I do demolition work.
Demolition expert. And what about you, Betty?
I'm a civil servant.
Are you really? Can we ask what branch?
Well, I'd rather you didn't, but if you really want to know, it's the Department of Health and Social Security.
Oh, DHSS.
Yes.
Oh, you'll be busy then at the moment.
Very busy.
Keeping very busy. Is it your own company, Graham?
Yes.
Yeah? And do you how many men do you have working for you?
About a dozen at a time.
Yeah. Really? Yeah. And that's a headache, keeping them working,
yes,
I suppose, isn't it?
It is these days.
Listen, now you've obviously had an accident there, haven't you?
Yes.
Tell us about it.
Well, it was many years ago when I was 11 years old.
Yeah.
It was a petrol can blew up.
What were you doing?
On a building site.
Yeah.
One of their old fires. Group of young lads. You know.
Yeah. Nice to have you with us. Lovely to be able to talk about that, Graham. It's smashing. Lovely, that. Marvellous. Betty, off you go to your little seat. And Graham, go and sit down over there. That's great. That's the second couple.
Yes, why not? Why not? Right. Let's bring on the third couple who are going to play with us tonight on this wonderful game of bullseye.
From Central, Peter and Steve Millington.
Steve, how are you, boys?
Fine, Colin.
All right. You're feeling right confident, are you? You're feeling all right?
I don't know yet, do we?
But you're all right. You're enjoying the so far.
So far.
It's all right. Well, you've only been on a minute, so it's nice and settled. Are you married, Pete?
Yes, I am.
Yeah.
And
yes. Both married. Families?
Yes.
How many?
Boy and a girl, too.
Boy and a girl.
No.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Are you related?
Brothers.
You're brothers?
Yeah.
Aye. You have a look of, you know... Aye. Well, that's very good. How's your dad, Lee?
Average.
Do you play for a pub?
I play as an enthusiastic amateur.
I see. And obviously you play a fair game to have even got on the game. What about your general knowledge? Obviously it's fairly good.
Reasonable.
Yeah.
Get on.
Do you read a lot?
Anything I can get my hands on. Papers, anybody's.
Are you one of these pathological readers? You can just pick it up and
all
read it. That's great, that. What about your living? What do you do for a living?
Work at a motor dealer.
Selling cars?
Not selling them, repairing.
Bodging them up?
No, repairing.
You used to have the car, didn't you? You used to have my first car. It was two-tone, black and rust. I remember it. It was a wonderful car. Steve, off you go to your little seat. Over there, Pete. Smash it. Let's, yes, all right, welcome him. All nice and relaxed. Super. All right. Come and have a look at the board. We're coming up to the end of the year, so I'll just refresh your memories very, very briefly. It's the bullseye dartboard with categories round it, and in these categories, bonus areas, to be won by the darts player. Just to remind all of you, especially the dart players, the bullseye is worth £200. Isn't that marvellous? All right. Once the subject's been hit, it drops out of the game. We'll just remind you about that as well. Let's get on with it. Now, we arranged the order of play before we came into the studios tonight, and they're all sitting there ready to play the game. Right, the first questions are worth £30 each, so it's John to look at the board and choose a subject for Mickey.
Sport, please.
Sport. OK, Mickey. Sport he wants. And he's got it for you, and he's got a £50 bonus, so that's a good start for you. I think you're all right on this one, John. You're all right on this one. What is the first name of the tennis player Borg?
Bjorn.
It's absolutely right for £30. Well done. Now then, come on, Betty, choose a subject for Graham.
Showbiz.
Showbiz. All right, Graham. Here we go. Your mum wants a showbiz question. It's flashing to help you. It's there, £50 you've got before you answer the question. Right. Betty, I'm not sure about this. I'm really not sure about this. Who jumped to stardom in a leading role in Dr. No? I can tell you he had a number. He had three numbers behind his name. And he was it was an Irish first name, and it was Sean.
Sean?
Sean...
Connery?
Is right. Well done. That's marvellous. You're all right. Give us a smile, you're all right. Steve, come on, choose a subject for Pete.
Words, please.
Words, all right. Come on, Pete, see what you can do for Steve. Relax on this first round. £30 bonus you've got, and here's your question on words. Think about this one, Steve. What do actions speak?
Louder than words.
Is right. Absolutely right. £60. The score at the end of round one, John and Mickey with £80, Betty and Graham with £80, Steve and Pete with £60. We move on to round two. This time, the questions are worth £50 each. A little bit more difficult, and, of course, we've got less categories. Let's look at what remains. Food, places, affairs, that's current affairs, history, books, Great Britain and spelling. Right, come on, John, subject for your partner.
Spelling.
Spelling, right. Flashing to help you. No problem. £100 bonus you've got. Excellent. Marvellous. I think you could well do this as well. To be stealthy or secretive is to be surreptitious. Can you spell surreptitious?
S-U-R-E-P-T-I-T-I-O-U-S.
What a pity. One R short. You know where the R was missing, don't you? It's S-U-R-R. E-P-T-I-T-I-O-U-S. Never mind, your dart playing partner did well, you've £180. Let's move on, Betty. Choose a subject.
Food.
Food. Right, Graham. Mum wants food. Flashing to help you. £50 bonus you've got. Well done. £50 question on food. You will get this, Betty, just relax. What's the meat used to make Wiener Schnitzel? The meat.
Veal.
Is right. Good girl. Well done. Good girl. Come on then, Steve. What do you think for Pete?
Affairs, please.
Affairs. Current affairs we're looking for. Pete, for your partner, Steve. Is there £50 bonus you've got? And here we go, your £50 question on affairs. Yes, fine. How old is Her Majesty the Queen?
51.
is not right. Very, very close. Audience? 56 on April 21st this year. Right, at the end of that round gives us the scores. John and Mickey with £180, Betty and Graham with £180, Steve and Pete with £110, so it's all to play for as we go to round three. This time, the questions are worth £100 each. But we have lost a few more categories and they're that bit more difficult. Let's look at what we've got left on the board. We've got places, history, books and Britain. As we look at John, to choose a subject for Mickey.
History, please.
History. OK. Flashing for you there. £50 bonus you've got, and here's your £100 question on history. Could well do this, John, because you did say you read a lot. Which American coined the phrase the Four Freedoms in 1941? He said it.
Abraham Lincoln.
It's not. I did say the year for you as well to help you. Sorry about that. It was F.D. Roosevelt. I did say 1941, you didn't get... Never mind, you're still all right. You're still well in with a chance for the next round. Betty, choose a subject for Graham.
Places.
Places. OK, Graham, in you come. It's flashing to help you. Take your time to get your bonuses. £50 bonus you've got. Well done. Little bit of pressure now. Little bit of pressure now, isn't there? Never mind. Which ducal residence in Derbyshire is known as... The Palace of the Peak. And it's something house. It's something house, I can tell you that.
Derbyshire House.
It's not. Sadly, you'll kick yourself when I tell you. Chatsworth House. Never mind. We move on with £110 so far. Steve, choose a subject for Pete.
Britain, please.
Britain. All right. Great Britain, as we're now pleased to say we are. You got your £30 bonus. Well done. Which famous potter is associated with the creation of the Etruria Works near Burslem?
Wedgwood?
Is right for £100. Well done. Gives us scores. John and Mickey with 230, Betty and Graham with 230, and Steve and Pete came right back from the dead there, £240. So this is what we do to lose one of the two couples with £230. We ask the two dart players to come up to the hockey here, and we take... It's a sudden death. Nearest to the bull goes through to the next round. All right, so it's John up to the hockey first, please. I'm awfully sorry. Mickey to the hockey. Sorry, Mickey. Mickey to the hockey. One dart, as near to the bull as you can go. And that's fine. It's in the first ring out. Stand here. Come and stand with me, Mickey. Come on, Graham, when you're ready, old son. Let's get nearer to the bull than Mickey. And he's done it. He really has done it. It is closer. I assure you it's closer. So, sadly, we've got to say cheerio to John and Mickey. Come on into the desk here, boys. Really, very, very close, wasn't it? Much closer, wasn't it? I know you knew it. Nice having you. Honestly, boys, it's been marvellous having you with us. Have the bullseye darts and the pen there. And you've £230. Now, these are in tens. I think there's... I better count it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9... 10. You want to check that?
No,
you trust me, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is the first round. This, do you realise? The first round, people going out 200, 10, 20, £30. Has it been worth your coming?
It certainly has, yeah.
And it's been lovely having you because you've been two right grand lads. Put that in your pockets. Have that courtesy of Central. Put it away. Thank you very much.
Thanks very much.
Give them a nice round of applause. Well done. Well, 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 well. Three couples tonight are going to have a super Christmas, aren't we? We've still got two left. And here in the next part of the game, we use a traditional match play dartboard. Just to remind you what goes on here, we ask the two remaining dart players to compete in three rounds of darts against each other. The highest scorer in each round wins for his partner a question. And the value of that question is the winning score. Now then, boys, it's pounds for points. OK, Graham, up to the hockey. As many as you can for a question for your partner. Come and stand with me, Pete. It's over to Tony.
First round, Graham's a throw. Single 5. It's treble 20. And another treble 20, that's 125. Pete. beat, a lot to do. 125 to beat. Single 5. Single 20. And another 5. That's 30 scored. First round to Graham.
With Windsor question for Betty. Worth £125. The decoration OM is limited to 24 eminent men and women. What do the initials OM stand for?
Order of Merit.
Is right for £125. Well done. 3-5-5, plays 2-4. We're moving to round two. Over to Tony.
And once again, Graham throwing. Single 5. Single 20. Another 20, that's 45 for Graham. Pete with 45 to beat. Single 18. Another 18. And a 16, that's 54. Second round to Pete.
OK, question for Steve. And this is worth £54, Steve. Which very large member of the bird family is unique in having only two toes?
Heron?
It's not, so we can offer it to Betty, and it's worth £45 to you, Betty, if you can tell us which very large member of the bird family is unique in having only two toes.
The ostrich?
The ostrich is right for £45. £400 plays £240. Over to Tony for round three.
And the final round? It's Graham to throw. Single 5. Single 5. And that's treble 20. That's 70 for Graham. And Pete, moving to the hockey. 70 to beat. Single 5. Single 9. Single 20, that's 34. Third round to Graham.
Right, Betty, here's your question. It's worth another £70. Part of which English county is known as the Dukeries because it contains so many stately homes? The Dukeries. Which county?
Bedfordshire.
It's not. It was a very intelligent guess, actually. Now then, come on, Steve. For £34, the Dukeries.
In Sussex.
It's not, and I know why you're thinking that, because of the royal family being... It's, in fact, Nottinghamshire. Never mind, at the end of that round, Betty and Graham have £400, but we've got to lose Steve and Pete. They've done very well, £240. Come on, boys.
Well done, lads.
Well done.
Well done. You were great there. You really were super. You've got here two bullseye tankards, which are all engraved. You've got the darts and the pen, and £240. So it's been worth you coming, hasn't it? You'll spend a few bob there at Christmas, won't you? Make a fuss with the family. So. We'll see you in a couple of throws. Well done. Take those without a confidence. Love to have you.
Who's behind the door? It's number 4.
Selected Tesco Fire Pit products are now 2 for £8 with your club card or app. That's dinner sorted.
Today this could be the greatest day of our lives. Oh, and the world comes alive.
Up to 60% off summer sale now on. Go outdoors, discover freedom.
At Frontline, we know your pet helps you feel better, happier. You can do the same for them with Frontline Plus. It kills fleas and ticks on dogs and cats, plus stops flea eggs from hatching in your home. Frontline Plus, the UK's best-selling flea and tick protection for our best friends.
Are your old freestanding wardrobes a waste of space? We'll help you uncover up to twice the storage space of freestanding wardrobes. All Sharp's wardrobes are created to fit more in, maximising every millimetre of space and tailoring the perfect storage solutions. Trust Sharp's to create beautifully organised space. Our half-price sale is now on. Book your free home design visit. Go to sharps.co.uk.
Say hello to Chase, the digital bank that makes every day rewarding.
What does that mean?
Well, you get 1% cash back on your everyday debit card spending.
Like on this coffee?
Absolutely.
Why has my debit card got no numbers on it?
All your card details are stored in the Chase banking app, so no one else can see them.
Will I be speaking to a robot if I call customer service?
Nope, just a few taps of the Chase banking app and you're through to a real person.
Oh.
Sorry.
So, who are you again?
Chase. We're a digital bank that's already trusted by millions of customers in the US.
How many millions?
Well, over 56 millions.
Blimey.
Say hello to rewarding banking. Chase.
Now that's what I call lucky.
Welcome back to part two of this special Bullseye. Now then, we're going to bring on stage probably the most famous figure in darts at the moment. Please welcome, all the way from Scotland, Jockey Wilson!
Jockey enters wearing his personalised shirt.
Hello. Oh,
thanks. Nice to see you.
It's nice to see you again, Jim.
Tell us about the year you've had.
I've had a great year, Jim.
Marvellous.
I mean, I won the British Professional at the tail end of last year.
That's right.
Won the British Open in January.
Yeah.
Then I won the World Professional. What more can I ask
Well, I mean, incredible.
The only thing I could ask for is to be number one. I'm number two at the moment, but I'm not complaining
about
that.
Well, you're working hard at it anyway. We'd like you to give a nice warm round of applause to Jock as he throws for charity tonight. Jockey Wilson. Go on, sir.
Sir's Jockey, world and British professional champion. Single
five.
It's treble seven. 21, 45 scored. Still six darts. And Jockey a lot to do with six darts. Single 20. Another 20. And that's a treble 20. 100. Jockey then 145. Three to go. Single 20. Another 20. And that's another 20. That's 205.
Well, don't you apologise to us. Always nice to have you on the show. We'd like to bring the couple in who chose the charity. Tell Jockey about the charity tonight, you two, because we know it's something particularly special to you. Go on, tell us about it.
It's for a local hospital, West Hearts in Hempstead,
yeah.
And it's for a brain scanner machine.
Right, right. So the money really is going to a worthy cause. I'm sure you'd like to thank this gentleman who's got for you tonight. £205.
Thank you.
He's a lovely fella, he really is. Jockey Wilson, privileged to have you on the show. Ladies and gentlemen, warm round of applause. Right. Now then, it's all downhill now for you, isn't it? You never thought you'd get to this stage, did you? You really didn't. It's lovely to have you here. Now then, Bullseye Star Prize Board. You'll never forget it for the rest of your lives. Come and have a look at it. Now, I explained to you what to do, but as I said to you, you're over the worst now. Come and look at this. It's a test of memory as well as skill, of course. And I'll just refresh your memories. It's black segments and red segments. And in every red segment, we've got some super prizes.
In one, a cut glass brandy decanter and matching glasses on a gallery tray. In two, for the festive season, a hamper full of Christmas fare. In three, a 14-inch colour portable TV set with its own aerial. In four, a lady's 9-carat gold necklace. In five, for the children, a traditional wooden rocking horse. In six, a gentleman's sheepskin car coat. In seven, a traditional 25-piece old country roses dinner service. In eight, 25 of the finest Havana cigars. And Bully's special prize this week, what every woman dreams of, a full-length Scandinavian mink coat.
Now then, nine great prizes. We're giving you nine darts, six for Graham and three for Betty. OK, try and remember the prizes. Little rhyme, keep out of the black and in the red. You get nothing at all for two in a bed, so once you've hit a red, keep out of it. And don't forget Bully Star Prize on this special show. All right, in you go, Graham, and it's over to Tony.
And it's Graham throwing for the prizes. First three darts. That's a
bullseye! Marvellous! That's the mink coat. Dear, dear me, what a start.
That's red, it's number seven.
That's the dinner service.
Red again, number two.
That's the Christmas hamper, so what a marvellous start. 3-on-3. In you go, Betty. Keep out of the ball. Super that, super that.
So Betty with three darts, she'll have to be careful. Keep away from the ball. She doesn't have to hit that ball.
It's all right, it's all right.
Red number four.
Oh, that's a lady's gold necklace.
Oh, unlucky, it's in the black.
Okay, it's grim. In you go, Graham. Don't worry, I'll do that for you, because it's Christmas.
Not to take the darts. Still, three more darts.
What he's doing now.
But it's Graham throwing them. That's red number three.
Oh, that's a portable colour television. Oh, can't believe it.
Red again, number five.
That's the rocking horse for the family. A marvellous prize, that, for the kiddies.
What a throw.
Oh, dear.
One more dart. Red
the
again,
six,
number
the gent
six.
Gent Sinclair. Let's have a look at what you've won. You have won the Christmas hamper, the portable colour television, the lady's gold necklace, the rocking horse, the gent sheepskin coat, the dinner service, and Bully's star prize, a super full-length mink coat. Can't believe it. Well, what a super show this is turning out to be. Now, we'd like you to consider a gamble. Right? Gamble those few prizes you've won there. Not a lot there, is there? A couple of prizes. You can gamble those for tonight's star prize, which is hiding behind Bully. All we want you to do is score 101 or more with six darts. Three for Betty and three for Graham. And you've got the time it takes that board to revolve to tell us what you want to do. Now, I know it's a big decision, this. You're going to have to think a long time about this, whether you gamble or not, aren't you? What are you going to do?
Take what we've got.
I should think you're going to take what you've got. And you have won, in fact, all those prizes there. £400 in cash, the £205 jockey won for you for the brain scanner, which we're delighted about. A lovely couple, ladies and gentlemen, as they go off with that wealth of prizes, give them a nice, warm Christmas round of applause. Well, 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 dear me, that was tremendous, wasn't it? So we bring back now the couple who came second, and we bring back Steve and Peter and ask them about the gamble. And Steve, well now, what do we do? You've £240 in your hand. You want to gamble that £240 for tonight's star prize? Hiding behind Bully. 101 or more, three darts apiece. What do you think?
We're quite happy with what we've got, aren't we?
They're quite happy with what they got, so they're not gambling. Give them a round of applause as we go off. Well done, lads. I don't know whether the world's ready for this or not. So we move on, and we move to the first couple who left us about 25 minutes ago, John and Mickey, and ask them if they want to gamble. Bring them back on stage. What do you think, boys? You know the score.
Well, big decision.
I think you're probably right. Ladies and gentlemen, they're going to go for the gamble. £230. Have you got the money?
Yes.
Yes, hang on a minute, hang on a minute. No, we do this
properly.
No, I trust you. You trusted me earlier on. I know there was a tenner short when I counted it out to you. I'll keep this for now. You get it back if you win, of course. Non-dart player first, right? And it's three each, 101 or more. And we really are rooted for you on this Christmas, well, nearly Christmas special.
And for tonight's star prize, John to throw the first three darts, needing 101 or more. It's five. Single 20. Well, that's out the board. That's 25 scored, leaving 76 for Mickey. Single 20. That's treble one, unlucky. Oh, so near yet so far, but that's the gamble.
Never mind. Come and have a look at it, lads. You were very close. Come and have a look at what it would have been. Oh, my goodness. Oh, you were a quarter of an inch away. Never mind. It's been a super show, really. Thanks very much for watching. Thanks to the incredible Jockey Wilson, Tony Green. Well, what can you say? Watch us next week, because the day wouldn't be the same, would it, without a bit of Bully. God bless.
'66. Give us a clickety-click if you can still hear us. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Dad, the dishwasher's stinky again.
And my mug is still dirty.
I know why.
Dirt and limescale can hide deep inside your dishwasher. Try new Finish dishwasher cleaner. It removes grease and limescale and now contains new odour removal technology. All clean.
And fresh.
Try new Finish dishwasher cleaner today.
I am what I am. I don't want praise. I don't want pity. I'm so if I love it, sparkle and it's bangle. From a different angle, your life is a sham tune. You can't shout out, I am what I am.
Don't let an allergy put your life on hold. Press play with Peary. Live life in Peary colour.
I'm getting some static from polyester blouses, and I can smell the hairspray from here. It must be time to play Bullseye on Challenge.
'58, you've made us wait long enough. What's your final answer? Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Bully the cartoon bull drops down from the public house sign and enters the premises where a darts contest is advertised. As people drink, he picks up a set of darts, takes aim and scores a bullseye.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you welcome your host for the evening, Jim Bowie.
Welcome to another edition of Bullseye. Let's get on with the game and meet the first couple tonight who are going to play with us on this incredible game of Bullseye.
From Tyne Tees, Eddie Goff and Rob Henderson.
Guys, and Rob, nice to see you. Where are you from, boys?
Hessel Nerill.
Hessel, yeah. No, yeah. I once did Hessel British Legion down there. The club, you know, they have the clubs, don't they? Yes. Hiding hole, isn't it? What do you do for a living, Eddie?
Pool attendant.
Oh, swimming pool attendant. Yeah. Great, great. What about you, Rob?
I'm a bridge officer.
On the new bridge? Yeah. Great, that's a marvellous construction, isn't it?
It's the largest single-span bridge in the world.
In the world, yeah, that's right. What about your domestic life? You married, Eddie?
Yeah, I've got two children.
Two children?
Yeah.
Can they swim?
Not yet, they're a bit young.
How old are they?
The eldest's a girl, she's three.
Three?
The lad's one and a half now.
When should they be swimming, do you reckon, as a pool attendant? Three, four, five?
Well, you don't start them well, Fab, because they just don't learn.
They just don't, that's right. But they do float now and again, don't they? The odd kid has floated, doesn't it? You know,
oh, the odd
baby
ones,
swimmers,
yeah.
That's right. What does your wife work?
No, she's just a housewife.
What about your general knowledge, Rob? I mean, what qualified you for the game? I mean, you must have been fairly bright to get through the audition.
Age.
Is it age?
Yeah.
Is that what it is? Well, it's lovely to have you both with us, all the way from Humberside, isn't it?
That's it, yeah.
All right, Rob, off you go to your seat there, and off you go there, Eddie. And the next couple tonight, we're going to play with us on Bullseye.
From Harlech, Alan and Joan Price.
And young Joan. How are you? All right.
Very well, thank you.
Are you relaxed?
Yes, yes.
From where?
Tredegar in South Wales.
Tredegar. And you were the heads of the valleys, that
that's
you
right,
said.
Yes.
That's where men are men and sheep are careful, isn't it?
That's true.
Is that right?
That's true.
What do you do for a living, Alan?
I'm a lorry driver with the local authority.
I see. For the council, that,
yes,
is it?
Yes, that's correct.
Right. What do you do, Joan?
Housewife.
But you've another academic interest as well, haven't you?
Yes, I'm an adult literacy teacher.
Oh, no, really?
Mm-hmm.
Teaching, what, semi-literates? Teaching them to read and write? All ages?
Right. Yes, all ages.
Because they do a super programme on television now, don't they, encouraging people to read? Because they do have hang-ups about reading, don't they? A lot of people...
Yeah, they get a bit embarrassed.
Yeah, that's right. Because it's... I don't know what it is. They do feel uneasy about not being able to read. And they shouldn't do, should they?
No,
they
shouldn't.
Because there are a lot of people can't read, and now it really is. It can be made so easy, can't it?
Oh, yes,
at places
easy.
Like you work at. Mm-hmm. Yeah, right. Any family?
Yes, two children.
Two children. How old are they?
Girl 11 and a boy 5.
It's lovely to have you with us. Have a good night. I hope you do very well. Joan,
thank
off you.
You
go to your seat there. And Alan there. Lovely. And the third couple tonight playing with us on Bullseye. Make them welcome.
From Anglia, Paul Barracliffe and Kevin Waterson.
Hello, Paul. How are you? All right. Kevin.
From a wonderful part of the world. Where are you from?
Norwich.
Norwich. That's where they have that fella does the Turkish bootiful, isn't it?
That's right.
Is it him?
Yeah.
Have you heard him, that fella? Yeah, bootiful. Have you heard him? Am I talking to myself or what? What's it like? It's a lovely part of the world, isn't it, down there? It really isn't. Everything's slower than everything else, isn't it, down there? The trouble is, to get there, it's like half a day. It's near Norway, isn't it?
That's right. That's
it's miles away, isn't it?
Real long trip.
What do you do for a living, Paul?
Double glazing inspector.
And what do you do, Kevin?
I'm an accountant.
Accountant?
Yes.
Really? For yourself or for a company?
For a company.
For a company, right. What about family?
Boy and a girl.
One of each. And obviously a wife?
Yes.
Happily married?
Yes.
It's all going well, is
yes,
it? Yes. Grand. What about you, Kevin?
I've got a boy and a girl as well.
Boy and a girl and a wife, and it's all going well?
Yes, fine, thank you.
Very boring.
Film anyway.
What about your darts, Paul? You play for a club or a team?
I play for a team, yeah.
A team? Good. Oh, that's smashing, because we do want you to do well. We want everybody to do well. Kevin, off you go to your little seat there. Paul,
thanks.
Over there. And let's have a look at this bullseye dartboard. Come and look at this. You know it by now, so I'll quickly go through it. Categories round the board instead of numbers, and bonus areas which can be won by the dart player. And just to remind you very briefly that the bullseye is worth £200. OK. Right. Once the subject's been hit, it drops out of the game. Let's get on with it. Now, we have arranged the order of players, we've told you over the past weeks, and that's done before we come on the air, so they're all sitting there waiting to play. The first round questions are worth £30 each. So, Rob, look at the board and choose a subject for Eddie.
I'll have sport, please, Jim.
Sport. OK, Eddie, in you come. It's flashing to help you, and don't forget your bonuses and the bullseye, of course. That's fine, a £50 you've got before even the question's asked. For another £30, Rob, whose team are called the All Blacks?
New Zealand Rugby Union.
Well done, a good answer. And early on, nice relaxed start. Come on, Joan, choose a subject.
Could I have food, please, Jim?
You can, with pleasure. Food. Alan, see if you can get a food question for young Joan. Got you a question on spelling, so there's no bonus, but you can score £30 by answering this. Please spell contemptuous.
C-O-N...
Good.
T-E-M-P-T-I-O-U-S.
P-T? You said U-O-U-S, didn't you?
I-O-U-S.
No, you said U, didn't you? You said... Say it again, U-O-U-S.
U-O-U-S.
It's right. Excellent. Absolutely right. For £30. Kevin, choose a subject for Paul.
Showbiz, please.
Showbiz. All right, we're having a go at show business. The lads from Norwich, bootiful. Can't get over that fella. And he hasn't got you a bonus, he's got you a question on affairs. That's current affairs, not being naughty. That's current affairs. All right, here's the question. Which famous musician was killed in New York in December 1980? He was one of a very famous quartet. He married Yoko Ono.
Oh, John Lennon.
John, I knew you knew it. Give him a nice round of applause. At the end of that round, Rob and Eddie with £80, Joan and Alan with £30, and Kevin and Paul with £30, but it's early days. Questions in the second round worth £50 each. We've lost a couple of categories, and, of course, they're a little bit more difficult. Let's look at what we've got left. Food, places, showbiz, history, books, words, and Great Britain. So, Rob, look at the board and choose a subject for Eddie.
Great Britain, Jim, please.
Great Britain this time. Come on, then, Eddie. See if you can do it again. £50 you've got. Well done. And here's your question. For another £50, I think you'll be all right with this one, Rob. In which national daily would you find a gossip column written by Nigel Dempster?
Guardian?
It's not the Guardian. I think the audience know it, do you? It's the Daily Mail. Never mind, you've still got £130. We move on. Joan, choose a subject for Alan.
History, please.
History this time. All right, Alan, in you come. Just relax, Alan, take your time. Early days. That's fine, you've got £50 there, and here's the question. Of what republic was Dr. Sun Yat-sen first president in 1912?
China.
Good girl. That's absolutely right, Chinese Republic. £130. Kevin, look at the board, choose a subject for Paul.
Books, please.
Books this time. All right, Paul. In you come. Flashing to help you on books. Fine. £50 you've got. And here's the question on books for another £50. In 1973,
Norman Mailer wrote a biography of an American sex symbol. Who was that sex symbol? It's got to be worth an educated guess.
Reckle Walsh.
It wasn't. Sadly, it was Marilyn Monroe. Never mind, at the end of that round, Robin Eddy and Joan and Alan with £130 each and Kevin and Paul with £80, but there's a lot to play for as we move to round three. The question's worth £100 each, a little bit more difficult, and, of course, we've lost a couple more categories. Let's see. Look at the remaining ones. Food, places, showbiz and words. Rob, what about it for Eddie?
Places, please, Jim.
He'd like a question on places. Eddie. He's there again, £50 again. He really has done very, very well. You may do this, Rob. What is the capital of Syria?
Damascus.
Excellent answer. £100. Marvellous. Oh, tremendous. Come on, Joan, £130 you've got. What do you think?
Showbiz, please.
Showbiz. All right. Come on, Alan. Let's see if you can stay in showbiz to the next round. He's there. He's got your £50, Joan. And here's the question. On showbiz for £100. What was special and unexpected about the cast in the National Theatre's recent revival of Harold Pinter's The Caretaker? It's got to be worth a guess.
Were they amateurs?
They weren't. It was an educated guess as well. In fact, they were all West Indian. Oh. We're all West Indian. Never mind, we move on to Kevin and Paul. Bearing in mind your score, Kevin and Paul, what do you want him to do, Kevin?
Words, please.
Words. This time, words. It's flashing to help you. Words, there we are. Just... It's there. He's got a £100 bonus for you there. In which direction is retrograde motion?
Backwards. Reverse.
Backwards is another £100. Well done. So the scores at the end of that round are Robin Eddy with £280, Joan and Alan with £180, and Kevin and Paul came back from the dead there with £280. So we've got to say cheerio to Joan and Alan. Haven't done badly. Come on, in you go. Well, you've done all right, haven't you? You've done all right. And you were nervous, I know you were, but you've really done very well. Nothing to be ashamed of. There are your bullseye darts and the pen, and, of course, £180. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 100. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. £180. We'd like you to take that with our compliments. It's been a privilege having you on the show. Best wishes to all the family. All right. Been lovely having you with us. Give them a nice warm round of applause. A super couple. Now we move to round two, and here we use a normal again, traditional match play dartboard. Come and look at this. Just remind you about it, although I'm sure you know it by now. Here we ask the two remaining dart players to compete in three rounds of darts against each other, and the highest scorer in each round wins for his partner a question. And the value of that question is the winning score. So it's pounds for points, lads. OK, Eddie up to the hockey. Almost time we make one. Over to Tony.
Round one, Eddie to throw. That's a good start, treble 20. Single one. Another 20, that's 81.
That's a super score to start. That really is very, very good. Stand here. Back to Tony again.
Paul needing 81. 20. Single 20. Single 18. And that's another 20, that's 58. Round one to Eddie.
Right. This question is a very valuable question, Rob. It's worth £81 to you. When a doctor is referred to as a GP, what do the letters stand for?
A general practitioner.
For £81. Give you 361, plays 280. Over to Tony for round two.
Once again, Eddie throwing. Single 20. Another 20. And that's a single one, that's 41. Paul then moving to the hockey. 41 to beat. That's a 5. Single 20. A
Another 20-45, second round to Paul.
Right. Here we go, Paul. Paul's earned a question for you, Kevin, worth £45. What was the nickname of the 7th Armoured...